We want to witness to you. We want to testify to you about that name, Jesus. And I don't know if you've ever heard of that name before. I don't know if you've ever encountered that name before. But my friends, you came out here today to testify and witness to you about that name. Hallelujah. That name is that name that is higher than every name. Hallelujah. In Radington today. And so we want to share to you, my friends, that message of reconciliation, the message of justification, how you can be put right with God, you know, by faith. Because the Word of God tells us that every human being has sinned, and the Word of God says, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. And so we see a lot of turmoil, a lot of chaos in the world going on today, you know, in our society, in our community, because of our sin. And you see, the Bible says that when lust hath conceived, it bringeth forth sin. And sin, when it is full, bringeth forth death. And so we need to realize, my friends, that when at the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth, God gave a choice to Adam and Eve, either to eat from the good of the tree of knowledge and evil. You see, God has given us a free will, so we cannot blame the devil nor God. It's up to us. It's our responsibility. God has given us that free will, that free choice to make a decision. Either we disobey or obey God. And you see, our community and our society today, we have disobeyed God. And so we see a lot of immoral things in our society. You know, adultery, homosexuality, all these kinds of things. You know, pornography. You know, in our society, you know, in our community, there's a lot of people, you know, committing suicidal thoughts because of drugs, you know, because of sin. And sin is so destructive. Sin is what destroys our community and our society. And that's why we see a lot of crime. That's why we see a lot of these things happening in the world today. You know, marriage, family, you know, broken, there's divorce going on. And we see that you know, that woman, instead of the husband in the house being, you know, having that authority in the house, but now is the woman having the authority in the house, you know. But the Bible tells us that it should be, that the wives should submit to their husbands. And you know, we came out here to testify to you about, you know, that we see this chaos, we see this sin is so destructive, and it's destroying our society and our community. And we need to realize, somebody needs to realize, that in today's generation, the problem is sin. The problem in today's generation is sin. And that's why we see a lot of murder, a lot of killing, a lot of violence in the world today, as a result of sin, as a result of disobedience to God's word. And because, you see, we have disobeyed God, you know, because we have disobeyed God's law, there is a consequence. Because we have disobeyed God, the Bible says, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. We all broke God's law, and nobody is perfect. And that is why we came out here today to testify to you about that name, his name Jesus, that there is hope for you, hallelujah, that there is somebody who took up our sin, that the Bible says that he took up our infirmities and our disease, you know, upon himself, that he bore our sins on the cross in his body, that we might die to sin and live for righteousness. And by his stripes, you have been healed. And we came out here today to testify and witness to you about that name. And his name is Jesus, because we are here today to warn you people that time is short, that Jesus Christ is coming again very soon. And that is why we see a lot of pestilence. We see a lot of earthquake, wars, rumors of wars, kingdoms against kingdom. You know, I just read in the news today that I just heard in the news, you know, that somebody's trying to threaten France, you know, Paris to bomb, you know, in France. You know, you know, we see a lot of these things going around the world. And we came out here today because to tell you that Jesus Christ is coming again very soon. That Jesus Christ is coming again very soon. And I want to ask you a question today. Is your life put right with God? Is your life, are you justified before God? Is your life put right with God? What kind of a lifestyle are you living? What kind of a lifestyle are you living? Are you living a lifestyle of sin? You know, and so we see these things going on in our community, in our society, a lot of abortions, people committing divorce, you know, these things, because as a result of sin. And we see sin is so destructive. It's like a disease. Sin is like a cancer that has spread throughout humanity. And so, you know, we're talking about this social distancing, but are you distanced from God? Are you separated from God? Because the book of Isaiah 59 verse 2 says, but your iniquities have separated you from your God, and your sins he has hidden his face away from you so that he will not hear. And so we need to realize that sin is like a virus. Sin is like a disease that has spread and infected every human being in this world. And you see, we cannot try to guard with our good works. You know, a lot of people might say, you know, we can go up to heaven by good works. But it's not about good works. Ephesians 2, chapter 8, verse 9 says, "For it is by grace that you have been saved through faith. It is a gift of God, not as a result that no man should boast." You see, a lot of people say, "Oh, I'll just be good to my neighbor. You know, all of my life I can do charity. I can do all good things." There's nothing wrong with that, my friends. But you see, the thing is, we need to trust what Jesus Christ did for us on the cross. That Jesus Christ laid down his life for you on the cross because of his mercy, because of his love, and because of his compassion for you. That the Bible says in John 3:16, "For God so loved the world that he gave us his one and only begotten Son, Jesus, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish but have everlasting life." You see, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. We were made from the dust, and unto the dust we shall return. My friends, time is short. God created animals and human beings in this world. But there's going to be a time whereby we're going to face death. The Bible says it is appointed for man once to die, and then the judgment seat of Christ. I don't know if anybody's hearing me today, but I hope that you are hearing me today. I hope that this message is going to be in your heart, that this message that you're going to take home, that you're going to take this message of the gospel of Jesus Christ, that you're going to take it on board. Because my friends, time is short. The Bible says that we're going to be judged according to our deeds, according to what we have done, good or bad, in our body, the things that we do in this life. And so, my friends, are you living a lifestyle of sin? And that is why Jesus Christ came as the propitiation to amend man's sin, to become that sacrifice, unblemished, without defilement, because Jesus Christ was the perfect person who lived in this world. And you see, the reason why we came out here today is because all of us, we're going to have to die someday. And where are we going to spend eternity? Where are we going to spend eternity? You see, what does matter in this life? When you die, what will you do? You see, this world is only temporary. This earth is only temporary, but heaven is eternity. Where are you going to spend your eternity? You may have all the cars, all the money in your bank account. You may have everything, you know, jewelry, phone, house, a mansion. Everything in this world is temporary. All those things are temporary. But guess what? Heaven, eternity is eternity. Now, you see, when we die, you know, we're so fragile as human beings. We could step in this life into the next life. It's just at the side. It's like a line. It's like a road. You know, we there's a two crossroad. The Bible says, "I've set before you life and death, prosperity and destruction." Now, which way are you going to go? Are you going to disobey or obey God today? Because the only way you can obey God is through the grace of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And the word of God says, "Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your soul." And we, and you know, the book of Beatitude says that, you know, "Blessed are those who are meek in heart, for they shall inherit the kingdom of God." You know, the Bible says that blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, and they shall be filled. And the word of God says, "Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be added unto you." And that is why we came out here to testify to you about this short message about the good news of salvation. That Jesus Christ came to save us from sin. That Jesus Christ came not only to deliver us from the works of the devil, but to set us free from sin. The Bible says that that Jesus Christ came, you know, to save and to seek those who are lost. And today, if you are lost, if you're living in that lifestyle of sin, today is the time where your life can be put right with God. And what must I do to be saved? What must I do to be saved? To be saved, number one, you need to repent. Number two, because the word of God says, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand." Repentance is a change of mind. Repentance is a change of heart. Today is the day of salvation. And what must you do to be saved? "Whosoever calls upon the name of Jesus shall be delivered," shall be saved. But what does it mean to be saved? It means to be delivered from eternal damnation, to be preserved from that eternal damnation. Because when we die, we're either going to face heaven or hell. Now, which way? Where are you going to spend eternity? Time is short. Time is ticking. time is running short. The Bible says in the book of Ecclesiastes, discern the times, you know, shorten, redeem the time, the Bible says. Redeem the time, you know, our life is so fast-paced, you know, that we got no more time with God. A lot of people are so busy with their work. A lot of people go busy with going to the shop. A lot of people are so occupied and so busy in these days, just like the times of Noah. The Bible says that when the flood came, you know, people were too occupied marrying, building, and all these kinds of things. People were too much occupied. People were too much busy that they got no more time with God. And so the flood came and swept them all away. And so we came out here today to testify to you about that message of the gospel of Jesus Christ. That now is the time. Do not leave it too late. Now is the time to repent and turn back to God. United Kingdom, Ruddington, this is the time, Ruddington, to run to Jesus. This is the time to turn back to the Lord, the living God of Israel. And this is the time to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior. Accept that free gift that He is offering you today. And if anybody is hearing under my voice, if you are in your homes, if you are in the shops, if you are in that car, accept. You know, you could just pray in your car and accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior. If you're going through that bullying, if you're going through that depression, I don't know what you're struggling with in your life right now, but I want you to come because I want to pray for you today. I want to pray for you today. Jesus Christ want to set you free from that depression, from that anxiety, from that demonic oppression in your life, because that's what Jesus Christ came to do. He came to heal the brokenhearted. He came to mend the brokenhearted. He came to restore things in the earth. He came to restore back family. He came to restore our life. The Bible says that the devil comes to destroy, to kill, and to steal. But I came that you may have life and life in abundance. Do you really know what it is to live life? Without God in your life, there's something missing. There's a void. There's an emptiness in your heart if you don't have Jesus Christ into your heart today. And so if you're hearing my voice, if your windows are open, you know, if you're hearing my voice today, accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior. We're not forcing you, but it is your make a decision today to be His Lord and Savior, to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior. The Bible says, if we confess in our mouth and if we believe in our heart, God raised Jesus from the dead, you shall be saved. And I decree and declare that this word of God will penetrate even through the homes right now, even through the shops right now. Let it penetrate in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I pray salvation will come to this place in the name of Jesus. I speak healing and restoration in every homes, in every shop, and we bind the spirit of crime in this place in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. You see all these memorial, all these things here, you know, all the grave, you know, you see all this grave here. I don't know if you can see all the grave here beside the shop of your church here. You see, these things here, people already died. The Bible says it is appointed for man once to die, and then the judgment seat of Christ. It is appointed once, just once, for man to die. Now, where are you going to spend eternity? Because without Jesus Christ in your life, you're headed for hell. If your name is not written in the Lamb's book of life, you will be damned to hell. Look at this grave. Look at all these people that has died in this grave here. And if you don't have Jesus, I'm sorry, but you're headed for hell. And that is why today, whosoever calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. May God bless you. And if you want to pray or come right now, we can pray for you. God, may God bless you. We love you. We are praying for you. God bless.